the 305 checking in for the remix. You know they had a 75 Street Brazil. Well, this year's gonna be called Gaiocho. Que hola, gata, que hola, omega. And this is how we gonna do it. Dale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. I know you want me.
I went out for the treatment, as I said, nearly 2 years ago now. And when I got back, within 7 days, I did something rather incredible. I had been issued a National Health wheelchair because I couldn't walk 50 metres. Well, within 7 days of getting back, I walked about 1,500 metres into town. I videoed it, and ABC News in America was covering the doctor, Dr. Rader, and I sent the footage off to show them.
We told you about Dr. William Rader. He claims to have treated more than 1,500 patients with stem cells. Dr. Rader may be familiar to some viewers of Eyewitness News. He worked here as an on-air medical expert in the 80s. We first investigated his practice back in 2007. Our investigation led the BBC to Dr. Rader. They sent the patient to his clinic with an undercover camera. This is what happened when that patient tried to back out.
I was able to go away and have another think about it.
And then
come back, and I was...
Don't let her do that, because there's no more to think about.
What Dr. Rader doesn't know, Linda Oatley is wearing a hidden camera and secretly filming her visit to Dr. Rader's clinic in the Dominican Republic for the BBC.
Let's just get started. He can go get the money later. Let's just get started. We're going to start right now.
Stem cells are cell factories, able to turn themselves into almost any cell in the body, such as a heart, liver, or nerve cell. While the promise is there, proven treatments are still years away. But that doesn't stop Dr. Rader from making some pretty incredible claims on his website.
The list of diseases that fetal stem cells have an impact on is enormous. It includes things like Parkinson's, multiple sclerosis.
Number one, we see with all our MS patients that they do get better. We have patients who are walking, who are in wheelchairs. So I'm the only one in the world basically doing this.
We went to Dr. Rader's Malibu office for a response.
We're saving lives, and I'm the only one in the world doing this. I'm the only one in the whole world. So the doctors are against me, the pharmaceutical companies are against me, the religious right is against me.
Dr. Rader derides Dr. Evan Snyder as a so-called mouse researcher and says that undercover video,
no negative side effects,
is slanted.
So it was very prejudicial. But it's not important to Bill Rader because I'm a good boy.
Let's just get started. We're going to start right now.
I was pressuring them because I believed it was a real patient. And you're asking me if I would do that again. I probably would under the same circumstances.
Dr. Rader provided us with this video. He claims it shows another MS patient, Kevin Haggington, who was also treated at his Dominican Republic clinic. Kevin told Eyewitness News by phone from Bath, England, that just 7 days after Dr. Rader's treatment, he was out of his wheelchair and walking. We were not able to independently verify the circumstances surrounding the production of the video, nor his medical condition.
If so, ABC News, I can verify the video. I made it. I'm well known by the West Country media in England for my various news coverage. And well, the fact I got a video to you to put on your ABC News program in the States shows I'm not just anybody. Yes, I walked into town. You can see the various clips that shows I did do the journey from Excelsior Street and Woodcombe all the way through up to the corner of the parade in Bath. It's about 1,500 metres. So what do I think about Dr. Rader? You guys at ABC have been given a challenge. He's a bad guy, he's a second-hand car salesman. You've been misinformed. Dr. Rader is brilliant. He's the only one in the world. He's good. And he can help so many innocent kids that have got terminal conditions. It wasn't until then that I'd realised they had a negative campaign against the doctor. But I've met him, he's a lovely guy, he really is a lovely guy. He said to me, Kevin, the medical people want me to do double-blind trials. Give one group the real thing, one group a placebo. He said, I can't give your little child a placebo, a killer. He said, no, I refuse. So Dr. Rader's a bit like me. I agree. In the medical field, if you want to follow the institution, you must tick the right boxes and follow their established behaviour. But Dr. Rader is a pioneer. He's out in front. He's 20 years ahead of us here.
But yeah, stop this him. He's a good guy. Dr. Rader is opening the path, which has now been allowed here in England. I just noticed on news the other day, they've done the first embryonic stem cells into the eyes of two guys. Interesting.
These are the first human embryonic stem cells to be grown in Britain. They can be turned into any human tissue, and these could replace body parts that have become diseased. They could, for example, be grown into muscle to treat heart disease, or turned into cartilage for arthritis, or create skin to treat burns.
Well, the things that we're interested in are type 1 diabetes, Parkinson's disease, spinal cord injuries, and cardiac damage. Those are the four major human illnesses that we envisage human stem cells to sort of have their earliest therapeutic uses for.
Until now, researchers have had to get human embryonic stem cells from labs in the US or Singapore, and they've been expensive. This small batch of human embryonic stem cells would normally cost between £3,000 and £4,000. That was an effective financial bar on widespread medical research. But thanks to work carried out here, they could soon be available for next to nothing. The new cells will be stored at a purpose-built stem cell bank and available to anyone carrying out ethically acceptable research.
What's the latest news for multiple sclerosis? I went to Bristol French Hospital to Brahms. Brahms is a centre of excellence into stem cells. And whilst there, I was chatting with my doctor, Dr. Cottrell. During our conversations over the years, it's come to light that I do enjoy cannabis. And he said, you'll have to stop that again, our Charles. And I said, yeah, of course I have, I've stopped. And also, I flew out to the Dominican Republic. So, though they mean well over at Bristol French, trying to do everything the correct way, sometimes that might be that was slowing them down. Now, in the end of our conversation, they've told me they have started stem cell trials here. Now, these stem cells are from human stem cells. In other words, they'd extract some of my bone marrow and give it back to me. Now, I can see one warning sign here. The fetal stem cells come from embryos between 6 to 8 week period. I think it's before the 8th cell division. You know how the cells divide? 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, so on. They double, double, double. Up until the 8th cell stage, the cells are what they call totipotent. They can become any other cell. Later on, after the 8th division, they lose one gene. And so already they're starting to become, they're going to become a heart, a lung, or a leg, or an arm, or whatever they're going to become. So the adult stem cells, what are they able to do? Take those stem cells, turn the clock back to where it becomes totipotent, bring it forward? I don't know. Statistics. And me, I'm not quite the average person. A, I smoke cannabis. B, I've had fetal stem cells, so I'm not a number that fit easily into their perfect box that they'd obviously want to produce to get the long-term approval on all this. So I'm going to go back out for more treatment in the Dominican Republic. I don't think over here they can work at the fastest pace. The thing is, Dr. Rader is giving stem cells, which stem cells know what they're doing. They just rebuild the damage. He's helping MS, Parkinson's, diabetes, arthritis, cerebral palsy, so many different conditions. So after my meeting with Dr. Cottrell, it became obvious I wouldn't be shortlisted. The first trial that's just happened had was 6 people. The next will be 20. He said, don't get your hopes up, we've got over 2,000.
If you want to go for treatment, give me a call and I'll help you raise the funds. Don't think about it. Do it.